Hey everybody, my name is Natalie Duncan-Emmons. I wanted to thank you for listening to this episode of The Morning Show. I'm the creator, the producer, and the host of the show. We want you to check out our website. It's themorningshowwithnatalie.com. You can go to that website. You can see all about our sponsors, all about the show. You can even listen to live episodes while they're going on right there from the website. Another way to listen to the show live is go to Live365. You can download that app and just search for The Morning Show. It's right there. Super easy. We want you to hit the like button and subscribe to this channel, if you will. That way you can keep up with what's going on The Morning Show. Thank you. I hope you enjoy it.
Hey, friend. It's great to have you tuned into The Morning Show today. Here on The Morning Show, you'll hear your favorite Southern gospel music and some of the classics you'll never forget. And now, the hostess of The Morning Show, Natalie Duncan-Emmons.
When you wake up to the storm, and all you feel are the waves crashing against your boat, you wonder if anybody remembers you or the journey that you're on. When you feel discouraged from what you see on the news or the events going on around you, well, friend, cut it off. Don't look to the left or to the right. Look up. And when everything inside of you is screaming to be afraid, to accept defeat, or to hand our enemy a victory, well, you need to sing, and then keep singing. Sing it some more, for we are God's people, and that's just what God's people do. Well, we sing.
He said, sing from a laughing heart, just sing when the night is dark, just sing. Let your joy explode and let music fill the air.
Joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all.
Then he said, sing from a laughing heart, just sing when the night is dark, just sing. Let your joy explode and let music fill the air.
You can sing
when there's nothing else to do. Sing
the meeting.
Natalie Duncan-Emmons, you are listening to The Morning Show. Today is episode 300 for The Morning Show. How about that? 300 episodes. Just another reason to celebrate God's goodness and faithfulness and to testify of the great things He has done for us. To God be the glory. We are anticipating 300 more, and maybe we'll get a little better every single time. Psalm 62:6 says, "My soul, wait thou only upon God, for my expectation is from Him." We are expecting great, great things. I hope you will stick around to see what lies ahead. No other place I'd rather be than right here with you on this Friday morning. It's going to be a great day. Just wait and see. Keeping things rolling with Jim and Melissa Bree. Here they are.
Walking out this morning beneath the blue skies of your grace. All my sin forgiven and all my shame erased. And I thought to myself, why you're smiling so much? You know who you were and you know what you've done. But then I thought to myself, I'm completely redeemed and I'm loved. 'Cause you are the
circumstance, I'm lifting grace.
everybody, cause I'm talking to you. The Lord is the only one to carry you through. You better get ready, cause I'm telling you why. The Lord is coming from his throne on high. Going down the valley, going one by one. We're gonna be rewarded for the things that we've done. How you gonna feel about the things he'll say
on that judgment day?
Everybody's gonna have religion in glory. Everybody's gonna be singing that story. Everybody's gonna have a wonderful time up there. Glory, hallelujah, brother. There's a reckoning and a coming in the morning. Better get ready, cause I'm giving you the warning. Everybody's gonna have a wonderful time up there. Now get your holy Bible in the back of the book. The book of Revelation, that's the place you must look. If you understand it, and you can if you try. The Lord is coming from his throne on high.
The things he said, he said he's coming back again to raise the dead. Are you gonna be among the chosen few? Will you make it through?
Well, everybody's gonna have religion in glory. Everybody's gonna be singing that story. Everybody's gonna have a wonderful time up there. Glory, hallelujah, brother. There's a reckoning coming in the morning. Better get a ready, cause I'm giving you the warning. Everybody's gonna have a wonderful time.
Trammell Quartet, Wonderful Time Up There. Want to remind you about the upcoming concert on March the 31st. We're calling it A Night to Remember. The Browders, Southbound, Reggie Spires, and the legend Ronnie Henson. They're all going to be at Salem Baptist Church on March the 31st. That's a Friday night, 2 weeks from tonight at 7 o'clock p.m. right here in Lake Mississippi. We are thrilled. We are beside ourselves with anticipation. I hope that you will bring somebody with you when you come, and you can win one product off of each of these artists' table if you'll just share this event. You can share it on social media, share it however you choose to do so, but you have to make us aware of it. Tag us in the post. Let us know who you invite so that we can put you in the drawing. We're going to be drawing on March the 31st on the morning show, and we hope that you'll win. We need you to help us get the word out. We really need your help. It's going to be a spectacular event. Here's Clint Brown now with a few words about what's going down.
Hey everybody, this is Clint Brown with Southbound, and man, I cannot wait. I've got to say, our favorite spot so far as a group singing around the globe has been Salem Baptist Church in Lake Mississippi. I'm not kidding. We love it. We can't wait to be back, and it's going to be a night to remember. My Lord. The Browders, Reggie Spires, Ronnie Henson, the legend, and Southbound coming back with a brand new album to Lake Mississippi. Don't you miss it. March 31st, A Night to Remember.
Soon I'm moving to a much better. my house. It's made of purest gold. It's a place where we'll never grow. See, this is an address. Change your notification.
This is Southbound, and you're listening to The Morning Show with Natalie.
The king told Daniel not to pray to his God anymore. I'll lock you in the lion's den and throw away the key to the door. But the very next day found Daniel down on his bended knee. The difference this time, he opened the blind so the whole wide world could see. I don't care what you say, I'm gonna pray anyway. Gonna lift my hands unto the Lord for the things he's done for me. I just got to get away. I find a place to seek his face. I don't care what you say, got a right to pray. They tell our children not to pray when they walk through the schoolhouse door. According to the Constitution, you can't do that anymore. I wonder just what old Danny would say if he were alive today. If the judge declared no more prayer, I believe old Danny would say, I don't care what you say, gonna pray anyway. Gonna lift my hands unto the Lord for the things he's done for me. I just got to get away. I find a place to seek his face. I don't care what you say, I've got a right to pray.
to say a quick word about Star C Suites. I've told you they can do any event that you've got coming up, big or small, but you don't have to have a big event coming up. Star C Suites can simply make you lunch. Did you know that? Yes, they can. I want you to go out to the fake book, look up Star C Suites. You can see that they can make Lunchables. They can make sandwich boxes. Even if you are catering an event, you got a lot of people coming in for something, this is an amazing idea if you're serving lunch to a lot of people. It's simple, it's quick, it's easy to hand out. This is a fantastic idea. If you got a retreat, you've got a ladies conference, you've got anything that where you are serving a lunch meal or a meal of any kind, well, this is the way to go. I'm asking you to go out to the fake book, look up Star C Suites Catering. Look at these Lunchables that they can put together for you. It would be a great meal just to send with your kids to school, for you to take with you to lunch. You don't have to do anything. You just pick it up from Star C Suites. You're ready to go. Or if you're having an event and you're going to serve lunch, going to serve a meal, well, I would suggest you just let Star C Suites take care of it. They can fix these up in a nice little package. You just hand them out to all your guests and you are ready to go. I tell you, I go with easy. That's the way I go. And Heather Compton over at Star C Suites can help make your life and your event easy. 601-900-9164, or you can just look them up on the fake book, Star C Suites.
God's people stood there trembling on the banks of the mighty Red Sea. God, we better get moving. We're coming after you and me. Moses then stepped forward and held his rod up high. He said, fear not, stand still. God is on our side. And the water parted right before their eyes. Crossed on over to the other side.
So, sister, grab your tambourine.
Grab your tambourine.
There's victory in the camp. Satan's been defeated. Sing your song, let's dance.
Ministry and more. It's the Morning Show with Natalie Duncan-Emmons.
You're listening to the Morning Show. And now, with your patriotic point of view, here's Larry Gresson.
St. Patrick's Day is celebrated annually on March 17th, the anniversary of St. Patrick himself in the 5th century. The Irish have observed this day as a religious holiday for over 1,000 years. On St. Patrick's Day, which falls during the Christian season of Lent, Irish families would traditionally attend church in the morning and celebrate in the afternoon. Lenten prohibitions against the consumption of meat were waived, and people could dance, drink, and feast on the traditional meal of Irish bacon and cabbage. St. Patrick is the patron saint of Ireland and its national apostle. Perhaps the most well-known legend of St. Patrick is that he explained the Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, using the three leaves of a native Irish clover, the shamrock. Since around the 9th or 10th century, people in Ireland have been observing the Roman Catholic feast day of St. Patrick on March 17th. The first St. Patrick's Day parade took place not in Ireland, but in America. Records show that a St. Patrick's Day parade was held on March 17, 1601, in a Spanish colony in now St. Augustine, Florida. The parade and a St. Patrick's Day celebration a year earlier were organized by the Spanish colony's Irish vicar, Ricardo Artur. More than a century later, homesick Irish soldiers serving in the English military marched in New York City on March 17, 1772, to honor the Irish patron saint. Enthusiasm for the St. Patrick's Day parades in New York City, Boston, and other early American cities only grew from there. I'm Larry Gressick with your patriotic point of view. Oh, happy St. Patrick's Day.
The patriotic point of view was brought to you by Joe McGee Construction. Joe McGee Construction believes family is one of God's greatest gifts. Family owned and operated for the past 33 years, Joe McGee Construction is the proud employer of some of Mississippi's best tradesmen. Together, we are supporting our communities and working hard to ensure that every commute to work and every ride to school brings us safely home to our loved ones. Valuing faith, family, and the Magnolia State, Joe McGee Construction is building safer roads for a better Mississippi. Joe McGee is my friend, and I thank him for helping us bring you the best mix of Southern gospel music, along with your patriotic point of view here on The Morning Show. We're here to let the world know God's got a song, and it is the song of salvation through Jesus Christ and Him alone. And we will sing this song, and we will play this song as long as we have breath in these bodies. And then the Lord will give us a new song, a song that only the redeemed can sing. And we will sing that song through all of eternity. My name is Natalie Duncan-Emmons, and you are listening to The Morning Show.
My name's Mary Ann. My name is Bonnie. Myla Jane's here, too, and you're listening to The Morning Show with Natalie. We love you, Miss Natalie.
Please be so careful of what Duncan, pastor of Salem Baptist Church in Lake, Mississippi. I would like to invite everyone to our revival beginning Sunday, March the 19th through Wednesday, March the 22nd. Sunday services start at 11 o'clock a.m. and 6 o'clock p.m. Monday through Wednesday will be 7 o'clock p.m. Dr. Danny Lanier will be the guest speaker, and we would love to have you come and join us.
We're going to shout the glory down. Join in that heavenly sound. Toe tap and hand clap in revival. We're going to stand and testify. Hands lifted up to the sky. Face stir and shake the earth. Revival.
Hard times, if your long days turn to long nights, if you're drowning on the inside with every beat of your heart, if there's dust on your Bible, if your soul's needing a revival, well, even if it's been a while, you can come as you are. God loves people like you, 'cause God loves people like me. Lost and hopeless sinner that mercy has redeemed. And if you feel like he don't, the cross is proof that he does. Praise the Lord, oh hallelujah, that God loves people like us. Oh yes, God loves people like us. Yeah. Hard hand, and there's so much you don't understand. Fighting battles with the question running through your mind. But if you're thinking that it ain't true, 'cause how could anybody love you? Precious in his sight, we are children to a father, gave his own to give us life. It don't matter where you are, it don't matter who you've been, or when, if you have forgotten, let me tell you once again, God loves people like you, 'cause God loves people like me.
St. Patrick's Day. Yes, it is. March the 17th. It's always on March the 17th because that was the St. Patrick's birthday. That's why we celebrate it on March the 17th. But there are a few facts about St. Patrick's Day that may surprise you. There have been a few things I got wrong on the morning show. I've been proven wrong about a couple of things, but these facts are true. I know this is right. It's an Irish holiday. We all associate St. Patrick's Day with Irish. We all wear green on this day so you don't get pinched, right? Well, did you know that St. Patrick was not even Irish? He was not. He was not. He was actually British. It is believed he was born in either Wales or Scotland. And this is probably the most frequently misbelieved fact about St. Patrick. He was actually abducted. He was kidnapped when he was about 16 years old, and he was brought to Ireland as a slave. He was then forced to tend sheep for many years in the mountains of Ireland. That's how he got to Ireland, but he is not Irish. He is British. And his name was not even Patrick. The whole world celebrates St. Patrick's Day. That was not the man's name. Patrick was a nickname that he picked up along the way. His real name, now I'll make a joke of this, trying to pronounce it. I'm looking at it, but his real name was Mwan Sukau. Now that's it with a southern drawl. Look, I vote Patrick. I'll never say that the same twice. If you could see it written out, you'd say Patrick too. I get why they called him Patrick. I say that was a good choice. Nobody could say the man's name. That's why they called him Patrick. And have you ever heard the story about St. Patrick banishing snakes from Ireland? I heard that story in school. I was told that in school. But the truth is, that is a wise tale. Nothing could be further from the truth. St. Patrick never banished a snake from Ireland. It's all symbolic. Now, in Judeo-Christian tradition, snakes are supposed to be symbolic of evil. So they came up with that wise tale, just a symbolism of what he did. Oh, and one more thing. St. Patrick never officially reached sainthood. No, they never even made him a saint. He was just a good Christian teacher. We just call him a saint. It's really all a myth, the whole thing. But I'm okay with it if you are. So there's some facts about St. Patrick's Day you may not have known. Just something interesting there. Just for fun. Just for fun. I hope you enjoy this St. Patrick's Day. It's always fun to celebrate a holiday, isn't it? Happy St. Patrick's Day.
If you're alive, you're dying. You can't live this day again. The clock just keeps on spinning. Everybody fears the end, but a 6-foot hole in the clay won't be enough to stand in my way. You can dig my grave, but I won't stay in it. Won't I get enough day? Got a one-way ticket. Lay me down in the cold, hard ground, but it's just the beginning. You can dig my grave, but I won't stay in it.
There's a lighthouse on a hillside, and it overlooks life's sea. When I'm tossed, it sends out a light that I might see. And the light that shines in darkness now will safely lead me on. But if it wasn't for that old lighthouse, my ship would sail. Now everybody that lives around us, they say, go on and tear that old lighthouse down. We all know the big ships, why they don't sail by this way anymore. And I just can't see no use in it standing round. Then my mind goes back to that stormy night when just in time, thank God I saw the light. It was the light from that old lighthouse, and it still stands up there on a hill, and I thank to him. On that old raging sea of life, Jesus is still that old lighthouse. And from the rocks of sin, you know, I still remember that old stormy night in my life when I had no hope, but then I saw that glorious light, and now I can clearly see.
If you're looking for grass-fed beef that's USDA certified, look no further than our friends at J&L Farms. J&L Farms raises 100% grass-fed beef with no additives. J&L Farms sells steaks, ribeye, sirloins, New York strip, or any of your favorite steak cuts. They also sell roast, hamburger meat, any kind of specialty beef you want, they can get it done for you. Grass-fed beef is a healthy choice because it's leaner and has significantly lower levels of saturated fat. It's also higher in vitamins and antioxidants. It's simply a healthier choice for your body. So for special pricing or requests, pick up locations, you need to call our friend Larry Mathis at J&L Farms at 601-917-8063. That's 601-917-8063. Be good to your heart. Make the healthy choice. Choose delicious, grass-fed beef from J&L Farms.
Hey, everybody, this is Joseph Habedank, and you are listening to The Morning Show with Natalie.
Was 30 pieces worth it when the truth is I might have sold him out for less? Can you see the way it hurt him? But it could have been me who hid behind that kiss of death. If I'm the judge of Judas, then woe is me. Turns out the only difference is that I believe. If he could love a traitor, a liar and a faker, if he could break the bread and share the wine, if the humble hearted Savior could wash the feet of his betrayer, then surely he could love a heart like mine. Ooh. What amazing mercy, how extravagant this overwhelming reach of grace. Though we are undeserving, he'll still meet the worst of sinners in their darkest place. And all I know to say is thank you, Jesus. And all I know to sing is
this is not going to help a lot of people, but it may help a few. We'll throw it out there. Are you thinking about repainting a room in your house or repainting anything in your house? Well, if so, you may want to know this, and I actually am. I'm thinking about repainting my bedroom. I'm tired of looking at the same colors in my room. I've not redone anything in my house since I built it about 9 years ago. So I really am thinking about making some changes and came across this. I want to share it with you. Here are the 7 top paint color trends for 2023. So if style is important to you, if you want to be in the loop of trends, well, you're going to want to know this. The number one paint color for the year is forest green. Yeah, forest green. It's not the same country green that was popular 15 or 20 years ago. No. This is a beautiful, vibrant, flourishing, deep green. All right, number two. Well, they're calling it grayge. It's a mix between gray and beige. How about that? Grayge. Number three is dark blue. I have one room in my house that is a dark blue, and I'm actually thinking about going with a dark, dark blue in my bedroom. That remains to be seen. I'll keep you updated if I decide to do that. But it is the number three trending color for 2023. Number four is eggplant. Now, there's a fancy word here. Aubergine? I don't know. I'm not going to make an idiot of myself. I don't know how to say it. But it's eggplant. That's what it is. I won't be going with eggplant. That's not my color. But it may be yours. Number five is a muted green. That would not be me either. I'm just not into the greens. Number six is a natural tan. I would think you couldn't go wrong with a natural tan. It's a very neutral color. So if you want to go safe, go tan. And then number seven is a moody brown. You'll have to use your imagination on that one. I have no idea what flavor of brown a moody brown is. We'll have to look that up. We'll all go Google moody brown and see what color it is. But there you go. That's some valuable information if you want to be in style and if you want to repaint anything in your house. There you go. There's the top 7 color trends for 2023. You're welcome.
We're glad you're listening this morning to The Morning Show with Natalie Duncan-Emmons. Stay tuned. The best is yet to come.
You're listening to The Morning Show. And now it's time for your pastor's perspective, brought to you today by Dr. Robin Brumfield with Trustworth Living Ministries at robinbrumfield.com. And now here's Dr. Robin.
Need a little help in what you're doing in your Christian life? Need someone to come alongside and let you know that you don't have to do it all on your own? In fact, the Lord Jesus didn't expect us to do anything spiritually on our own. When we do so, we're doing that in the flesh. What the scriptures teach us is that we need to lean on the Lord Jesus and let him work in and through us, using his power to accomplish the things that he wants to do spiritually in our lives. This is very evident in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 4. It says, "And my message and my preaching were not in persuasive words of wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and of power." He says that it is the demonstration of the Spirit of God and power that Paul was able to do the great things that he did. He said it wasn't because I was a really good preacher or I had really good sermons. It was because the Holy Spirit was there working in my midst, using his power to accomplish what God wanted to do. And he will do the same in your life. This is Robin Brumfield with your pastor's perspective.
I am Larry Duncan, pastor of Salem Baptist Church in Lake, Mississippi. I would like to invite everyone to our revival beginning Sunday, March the 19th through Wednesday, March the 22nd. Sunday services start at 11 o'clock a.m. and 6 o'clock p.m. Monday through Wednesday will be 7 o'clock p.m. Dr. Danny Lanier will be the guest speaker, and we would love to have you come and join us.
We're going to shout the glory down. Join in.
Pages, grab a Bible, look it up. You won't find a loophole to water down the blood. That crown of thorns was jagged, the nails pierced in the wood. We can't sugarcoat the story just to make the lost feel good. If that rubs you wrong, take it up with the boss, 'cause I ain't sanding off the edges of that old rugged cross. I ain't apologizing for standing on the truth. I won't stand before the Lord with some old lame excuse. I'm marching right behind him. He said don't count the cost. So I ain't sanding off the edges of that old rugged cross. And everywhere I go, the Lord told me don't worry if he steps on your toes. And the serpent likes to whisper lies into our ear. Like, don't believe the scripture, we don't need this part right here. Well, he's fooled that sense of garden. Hey, get behind me, hoss, 'cause I ain't sanding off the edges of that old rugged cross. I ain't apologizing for standing on the truth. I won't stand before the Lord with some old lame excuse. I'm marching right behind him. He said don't count the cost. So I ain't sanding off the edges of that old rugged cross.
gospel bus is headed north. The wide road takes you south. Don't get left behind, my friend. You're either in or out. I ain't apologizing for standing on the truth. I won't stand before the Lord with some old lame excuse. I'm marching right behind him. He said, don't count the cost. So I ain't sending off the edges of that old rugged cross. Go out and be a blessing. Tell the truth and trust the message. Don't send off the edges of that old rugged cross.
Well, Praise Fest is going on this week over in Branson, Missouri. I'm sure some of our listeners have been involved in that. The Kraft Family, the Booth Brothers, the Hoppers, Greater Vision, Gordon Moat, lots and lots of groups have been over at Praise Fest. Here's Chris Allman with Greater Vision to give us a little update about it.
Praise Fest Branson is always special to Greater Vision because it's a week that we can get together with a lot of our friends who travel, and we don't get to do that very often. We're doing a little bit different this year, and we started this last year. We're doing a prelude and encore. It actually starts on a Monday and goes all the way through Saturday. And the first part of the week is some more progressive things. Avalon comes in, had Point of Grace in this year, and some different artists like that. And then on the second part of the week, starting on Thursday, we have Greater Vision, of course, and the Triumphant Quartet comes in. Legacy 5 is here through the week. The Booth Brothers are here. So it's a real special time for Greater Vision. And it's an event that has really grown, and we're so thankful and proud to be.
But with the group High Road in almost every one of their posts and all of their pictures, I believe even on some album covers, if I'm correct, you see their dog. His name is Max. Max has just been along for the entire journey that High Road has been on. The whole time, Max is just a part of the group. And yesterday, they lost Max. Max was 16 years old. They said he just went to sleep and passed on peacefully. Said they were heartbroken over the loss of Max. If you go back and look at their Facebook page, you can just scroll through and see Max all through there. He looked like a wonderful dog. And I am very sad for High Road. We are sharing in the loss. I know they'll miss Max. Here's High Road now.
Just another Sunday morning, the normal church stuff. Preacher kept on preaching, just as I am played. It was just a small moment when I bowed and prayed. Not a lot was stirring this side of the sky, but oh, rolled down streets of gold, the loudest of angel bands played. The day I got saved, the day I got saved,
stronger day by day. For all I've longed for, I won't have to wait much longer.
The Father promised he would gather all his children unto him.
I can almost hear him call, come unto me. Oh, hallelujah, through the clouds we're gonna leave. Glory, glory, oh, happy day. I'm rejoicing and I'm ready for the change. This world of sorrow is not my home. I'll have no trouble laying down these earthly cares and woes. I've made my reservation at Calvary long ago. There will be no more sadness, no sorrow or pain. Glory, hallelujah, I'm ready for the change.
There's a crystal river flowing through the land that I'll possess, and the fragrance of heaven fills the air.
Oh, the sound of sweet redemption up and down those streets of gold.
There's something happening just around the bend.
Well, here comes David dancing round the throne again.
Oh, glory, glory, oh, happy day. I'm rejoicing and I'm ready for the change. This world of sorrow is not my home. I'll have no trouble laying down these earthly cares and woes. I've made my reservation at Calvary long ago. Glory, glory, oh happy day.
I'm rejoicing and I'm ready for the change.
Oh, wanna change this world of sorrow.
You remember back a few months ago, probably around November, the group Old Pass decided they would change their name. They made a big announcement, said they would be announcing a new name soon. Well, it took a little longer than they anticipated, but they have decided on one. Here's Steve Ladd to make the big announcement.
After a decision and an announcement back in December of last year, we decided to change our name and nothing musically or stylistically, but just a new direction with a new name. And then going through a personnel change kind of put that all on hold. And so we are now pleased to announce to the world that our new name going forward is going to be Anthem Edition.
All right, we're going to have to remember that. No more Old Paths. They are now Anthem Edition. It might be tricky. We'll get it eventually. Anthem Edition. I like it. Here they are.
Lord, it's me again, talking to my friend. I'm grateful I can always count on you. You know I've asked for help before, for you to open doors. And you've been faithful to forgive the foolish things I do. Those were the prayers of a young believer, and hopefully by now my faith has grown. If you made wine out of water at a wedding dinner, could you make my life a greater song? And let it be an anthem of your grace, symphony of praise, lifting up your name forever. And Lord, let me live a melody that would sing of Calvary and all the mercies I've been given. Then Lord, music to your ears. I want to know you more, like I never have before. I long to have a deeper walk with you, and I want to make you smile, singing all the while. Every song you give, I'll sing it back to you. Let it be an anthem of your grace, a symphony of praise, lifting up your name forever. And Lord, let me live a melody that would sing of Calvary and all the mercies I've been given. Then, Lord, let the song of my life be music to your ears. And let it be an anthem of your grace, a symphony praise, lifting up your name forever. And Lord, let me live a melody that would sing of Calvary and all the mercies I've been given. Then, Lord, let the song of my life be music to your ears.
Hey, everybody at Lake Mississippi at Salem Baptist Church. This is Reggie Spires from Georgia. I cannot wait to be with you on March 31st and all of the wonderful artists that are going to be there. We're just a couple of weeks away, and I'm so excited. I hope you're getting ready for it. It is truly going to be a night to remember. My friend Southbound's going to be there. The legend Ronnie Henson's going to be there. The Browders are going to be there. We're going to have a great time. You're going to be there. We look forward to seeing you. Georgia's on the way to Mississippi, so we look forward to seeing you guys real soon. God bless. Can't wait.
We're glad you're listening this morning to The Morning Show with Natalie Duncan-Emmons. Stay tuned. The best is yet to come.
You're listening to The Morning Show, and now it's time for You're Happy When You're Laughing with your friend and ours, Mark Bishop.
This is Mark Bishop, and you're happy when you're laughing. Now, years ago, we used to ride around to places in the back of a pickup truck. You can't really do that anymore. It's not considered safe. Today, if you're a full-grown man or a woman and you're still riding around to places in the back of a pickup truck, you might be asking yourself, is this the way that I thought my life was going to turn out? The only exception is if you're in a parade. If you're playing T-ball for the Kiwanis League, well, riding around in the back of a pickup truck is okay. But if you're all dressed up and you and your family's on the way to church, some folks might think they're watching an episode of The Waltons. What used to be a common thing here in America, it's got a stigma attached to it now. If you're still riding around in the back of a pickup truck today, most folks who see you are going to assume that you're on your way to take your prize laying hens to be judged at the county fair, or on your way to Walmart, one or the other.
The Patriotic Point of View was brought to you by Joe McGee Construction. Joe McGee Construction believes family is one of God's greatest gifts. Family owned and operated for the past 33 years, Joe McGee Construction is the proud employer of some of Mississippi's best tradesmen. Together, we are supporting our communities and working hard to ensure that every commute to work and every ride to school brings us safely home to our loved ones. Valuing faith, family, and the Magnolia State, Joe McGee Construction is building safer roads for a better Mississippi. Joe McGee is my friend, and I thank him for helping us bring you the best mix of Southern gospel music, along with your patriotic point of view here on The Morning Show.
Hey, y'all, this is Jay Perrick, and you're listening to The Morning Show with my friend Natalie. Stay tuned for my latest song, Down in My Heart.
All right, right after Jay Perrick, our featured artist of the week, Victoria Bowlin, she will be on The Morning Show right after Jay. My name is Natalie Duncan-Emmons. You are listening to The Morning Show. All week long, we have been featuring the singer, the songwriter, the speaker. Well, just about anything you can think of, she can do it. We're talking about Miss Victoria Bowlin, and this morning, she is here. And we're ecstatic about it. Welcome to The Morning Show, Victoria.
Thank you. I'm so glad to be here.
We're excited. And I don't really know where to start because you do everything and you do it superbly. You've won it all. Well, you've done it all. Girl, you've been busy.
I have been busy. I stay busy.
Yeah, I can tell.
Yes. I've been, honestly, I have my hands in a little bit of everything. And I do that just because I enjoy a little bit of everything.
Yeah.
So, music obviously is my first love, you know. Mm-hmm. As far as things go, I love the music. I love singing. I love songwriting. And a few years back, I started even writing books. I've got two books, out and then the Lord started using me to speak after the books came out and it's just been an awesome journey.
Wow. That's amazing. And you started so young, you were literally born
for this. I read that they put a mic in your hand at age two. So you got an early start.
I did. Mom would dress me up in the frilliest, laciest dress she could find and use hairspray and a curling iron until my hair was bigger than my head. So I've been doing this all my life.
singing at camp meetings, right?
Oh, yes, absolutely. I was raised in tent revivals.
That's amazing. That is amazing.
That's how I got my start with my family, traveling and singing with them. My parents have been singing together for well over 40 years. So when I came along 33 years ago, almost 34 years ago now, as soon as I came out, my mom said, I knew you were going to be a singer because you came out hollering.
She knew it.
Yep.
Well, we don't want anybody to go anywhere. We're just getting started. We're going to come back and talk about some of Victoria's accomplishments. And so many, there's too many awards that we could never cover all of them in one interview. It would take a whole day to cover everything she has accomplished and received. But we're just going to touch the surface in a little bit. And then we're going to talk about this new album that she has. So don't go anywhere. But I think a great way to get things going is by one from the new album. It's a good way to start. I love this one. It's called Gather Together. When we come back, we'll talk about this album. We're glad to have Victoria on the morning show. Received so many awards throughout the year. I can't cover all of that, but I'll just say a few things here that I wanted to mention that are pretty impressive on a resume. You have sang on the main stage at Gatlinburg Gathering. More than one time you've been a part of that. You have sang on the stage of the National Quartet Convention. That's no small feat. There's a lot of full-time artists who have never done that. You have sung at Dollywood. And let's go ahead and establish who you are, because some people who are listening that may not recognize the name Victoria Bowlin right offhand, they definitely know who 11th Hour is. So we want everybody to know that currently You are with 11th Hour, and 11th Hour was in the top five nominations for Favorite Trio of the Year by the Singing News in this past 2022. And don't tell Gerald Wolf, but I voted for 11th Hour as Favorite Trio of the Year 2022. Out of the top five, they were my favorite last year. I thought you were very deserving of that. So we want everybody to know you're connected with 11th Hour, because that's a big deal right there. Do you like singing with that group?
Oh, gosh, I love them. They are just wonderful. They are, and I would say this to their face or behind their back, they are some of the best people in the world to work for and travel with. I just love Amber and Garrett. They are, they love Jesus. You can tell it. You know it. It comes through in their lives, and they're the same on stage as they are off. And that's a big deal to me, is knowing that you're living what you're singing. And I can honestly say, because we're in close quarters most of the time, and I can tell you that they absolutely live what they sing.
Well, you would know. You're right there with them all the time. Yeah.
Yes.
And not only is the sound and the singers phenomenal with 11th Hour, but this is the truth. They put out some of the best songs that Southern gospel music has to offer. 11th Hour never waste a song. They have some of the best songs out there.
Thank you. We go through a very tedious process when we pick songs. And, you know, our goal is to find the songs that mean something to us, to the point that we convey that to others in a way that will move them, and not just in emotional way, but because it's not about the emotion of it. We want people to have a godly experience with these songs that we're singing, and the majority of the songs that we sing, we write. So we've had a hand in writing these songs, so we know where they came from. We know the trials and the struggles that we went through to get some of those lyrics. And we know the scriptures that back them and that base that were the songs were based on.
Yeah. They're personal.
Absolutely.
Yeah. My little boy is a fan of 11th Hour, Tate. And when you were talking about how they really are what you see on stage, that really is how they are. We experienced that at the NQC. He wanted to meet 11th Hour. That was one of his goals when he got there. He said, I want to find their table. Aww. I want to meet them. And they were, you guys were so kind. You didn't know him. I mean, you didn't have to be. He just walked up to the table and you took time to talk to him and to just, you know, to just get acquainted with him. And it made a lasting impact on Tate, and he has not forgotten that. He's a true fan. We all are.
So sweet. Yeah. So sweet. Thank you.
This is not about 11th Hour. It's about Victoria Bowlin. So I'm going to get back on track, and we're going to talk about this album, but I wanted to mention one more thing as far as in your resume and things that I've read about you. You also have a degree in biblical theology. You got that from the New Vision Bible College and Seminary. I was extremely impressed with that, Victoria.
Yes, actually, that was, for lack of a better word, it was just a God thing. I graduated high school when I was 16 years old. I had went through all of my, and got all my credits together to where I knew that I was called to sing and travel full time, but we couldn't do that until I was out of school. And so I prayed about how to make that happen as quickly as possible. And the Lord allowed me to graduate high school a year early. So I actually skipped my junior year, went straight to being a senior, doubled up on things, and graduated public high school at 16 years old. So when I graduated, I knew that I was not going to immediately go to college. I was going to get on the road full time, because that's what I felt led to do. But when all of that happened, you know, I thought, you know what, years went by, and I thought, I'm doing what I know that I'm called to do. And this is just what it's going to be. So schooling was really the last thing on my mind. But a friend of ours is actually the president of that college. And he came up to me and my husband one week. We were actually at the Singing in the Sun in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina that week. And he walked up to us out of the blue and he said, hey, have you ever thought about going back to college? And I said, honestly, we're so busy and God has blessed us so much that I don't know that we would have time for that, not to actually physically go anyway. But this is something that my husband really desired, is to go to a biblical college, because he's a preacher. So, you know, he wants to do as much as he can, you know, for that. So he asked us, he said, well, I would like to offer you guys a full scholarship to go through and get your bachelor's degree in biblical theology through New Vision Bible College. And it just floored us. It was something that we were not expecting at all. But it's like the Lord just kind of threw it in our laps. And he said, look, it is, you do it at your own pace. I send you the curriculum. You do everything from a distance. You never have to come in person. You can do everything, you know, online and through the curriculum that you're sent. And when you're finished, we go through everything, we grade everything, and you get your degree. And that's exactly what we did. I actually just, there was about a 6-month period that Aaron and I were in transition in moving from North Carolina to Nashville, Tennessee. And in that time, I had a lot of extra time to just sit and work on new music. I had time to work on school and things like that. And I thought, you know what, I'm just going to bear down and I'm just going to get it done. And I got it done way quicker than I thought yeah. I would. But it turned out to be an awesome experience. And I learned so much through that.
I mean, how incredible is that to have on a resume, a degree like that? Wow, that's incredible. Yeah.
Yeah, it's honestly not something that I ever thought that would be on my resume, honestly. But I'm thankful for that opportunity. And it's really helped a lot in my learning and understanding, yeah. and even understanding of the word to, yeah. and that's important when you're writing. So it all works together.
As the lightning strikes again, it's a little overwhelming to be caught in changing winds, but I'm not gonna wait for this old storm to pass. I'm gonna learn to dance in the rain. I'm gonna learn to smile through the pain. When the clouds of fear and doubt start rolling, choosing not to be afraid. I'm gonna keep myself encouraged when the skies are looking gray. 'Cause I know that God's still good and that's never gonna change. Gonna learn to dance in the rain. As darkness gathers round me, I stumble to the ground, and when I hear the voice of defeat, I tremble at the sound. But I'm not gonna give up, I will not turn around, 'cause every step gets closer to a brighter day. I'm gonna learn to dance in the rain. I'm gonna learn. When the clouds of fear and
let's talk about this album. I'm saying it is a new album. It is your new album. It's actually been out a few months, right? It's new to us. I mean, on the morning show, and it's new to me, but it's been out a few months. But this album is fantastic. And I'll say this, when you start listening, if you get to one song and maybe the flavor's not something that you like, it's not your style, just keep listening, because the next song's a little different and the next song's a little different. So everybody's going to find something on here that you like. And the incredible thing is, didn't you write all of these or co-write every single song?
I wrote all 12 of the songs. There's only one co-write on there. And everything else I wrote on this. And it was just, again, even this album was a God thing. It's something that I have been wanting to do for a while. I have not, until this project, I had not done a solo project in 4 years.
Wow.
And joining the group and being a part of 11th Hour, you know, I was like, look, that's my sole focus. That's what I'm took my focus in. But I had a desire to do a new solo album, because I wanted to get some songs out that I knew that the group wouldn't necessarily record, but that was me, you know, that I wanted to put out there and that I thought would bless people and encourage them. And as those songs started coming and I started writing them, I kind of put them aside and put them on the back burner and kind of started making a list of, hey, these are songs I would love to record on a solo album one day. And then things just started falling in place. I had musician friends start coming to me, hey, if you ever want to do a solo album, just call me. Producers, hey, if you ever want to do a solo album, let's do it, call me. And everything just fell into place and it all came together so quickly. Anyone who's ever recorded an album would know, and for those of you who don't know, when you go into the process, the song picking process honestly is the hardest part. Narrowing down what you're going to do, and once you get through that process, then finding the right producer, finding the right musicians, finding, you know, getting the right arrangements and all that, it's a long process. And sometimes people take, you know, anywhere from 6 months to 2 years to get a project out. And from the moment that we started song picking to the moment that it was finished, it was done in 3 months.
Wow.
The whole
thing. Incredible. That's unheard of, really.
It really is. It was so fast, and it turned out, in my opinion, I'm so proud of it, and not in a proper way, but just so grateful for how everything just fell in place and how the Lord just orchestrated everything together. And I love how everything turned out. And I got, this project was really special to me too, because I was a lot more involved in this particular project than I've been in any other project that I've ever done. I actually got to self-produce this project. I sang all of my own background vocals on it. I wrote everything on it. I even did down to the graphics on the project. So I had a hand in every step. I'm so excited about how it turned out.
Well, you should be proud of this. It really caught me strongly when I heard this. So you should be proud of this. Here's one off the album that I really like. It's called Dead Man Walking. And when we come back, we're going to talk about my very favorite song on the album. So don't go anywhere. More with Victoria Bowling right after this song.
That day, others hallucinations when they looked upon his face. They had watched him die, so they knew this could not be. Then again, he said he'd rise. So was this man?
Okay, Victoria, I was going to ask you, one of the questions I had was who produced this, but you told me you did.
I saw
in some of the reviews on your website, I saw something from Shane Roark about something he had produced from you. And I thought, well, I wonder if Shane produced this, but no, this is all you. This is strictly.
Yep. First one that I've done everything on. And I'm so pleased with it. Yeah. The last project that I did before this one, was with Chapel Valley, and Shane produced it and did a phenomenal job. And I even thought about having Shane produce this one because I liked the other one so much. But I just, when I got down to it and got brain about it, I thought, you know what? I think I'm just going to produce it and arrange it myself. And I sat down and the Lord just started giving all the arrangements and everything to me. And I just went with it. And I think it turned out, you know.
You made the right call. Well, if you can do it, absolutely do it. My favorite song on the album is the title track called Days With You. And I just want you to talk to me a little bit about this song because it's so different. And when you hear it, I don't know, it just kind of puts me mentally in a whole nother place. And the feeling is so authentic. You don't think really Southern gospel. When you hear this, you kind of feel country western. I don't know. And it's not 2023 country western. It's way back country western. It's just fun to listen to.
Country.
Yeah, it is. Tell me about writing this.
It's fun. So I am a big Patsy Cline fan. I'm also a big Reba fan in the country world. You know, there are three people that I really, really like in country music. And that is Patsy Cline, Reba McEntire, and Vince. And those three have had a lot of influence on that. On my stylistic, you know, part of my writing and my solo things. And when I go back and listen, if you ever ride in the car, I have such a plethora of music on my Apple playlist. I mean, you go from Southern gospel to contemporary to praise and worship to Black gospel to country to jazz, classical, and Black gospel, and you just all these different things, 80s, and mm-hmm. and there's just a whole I think I cover all of it, and the 50s, and I love that old school sound. So when I sat down to write Days With You, I thought, man, that particular country swing style, that old school style, is something I would love to hear come back personally. It's kind of like a lost art almost.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
But when I sit down and I hear music like that, it just puts me in a really good mood.
Yeah.
So I thought I would love to write a song in that style just for fun. Yeah. And so I thought about, man, what in the world would I even write about? And I started thinking about it. And every song that you hear with that kind of music is normally a song about being at a bar, my heart got broke, and blah, blah, blah.
Somebody
you know?
Cheated on me.
Yeah, exactly. And I'm like, man, how can I turn that around, but make it sound like when you listen to the first verse, you're thinking, is this a country song or is this a gospel song? I'm not real sure. And then you hear the chorus and it can be really taken either way. And then the second verse pulls it around into, oh, she's talking about Jesus, mm-hmm. you know? So it talks about how, you know, I've traded my sad time blues for Days With You. And it's talking about trading all the sorrow, trading all the things of the past that used to hold me and that used to have me down. I've traded that for spending time with the Lord and giving him my full attention and making him priority and making him my desire. Because once you know, there's scripture in the Bible that says he'll give you the desires of your heart. Well, up until a certain point in life, I had always misunderstood that scripture. And what that scripture really means is God is supposed to be your one desire. And when you make him your desire, and he is the desire of your heart, everything else that you ever wanted is yours because that is your desire. And he'll give you all that he can of himself. That's the point. He wants that relationship with you. So that was the whole basis of that song.
Yeah. Yeah. He's not trying to withhold anything from you. He wants to give it to you. Yeah, absolutely. Yes. Well, this is the kind of song that when it gets to the end, my finger just automatically hits go back and play it again. Just repeat this one. It's my favorite, and we have been playing it an awful lot on the morning show. I want to play it right now. We love it, Victoria. We really do. Here it is. It's the title track from the album. Here's Days With You. To encourage everybody to get this album. Now, it's been out a few months. You've got it's easy to get. Apple Music, iTunes, YouTube, Spotify. I'm sure you can go to the website and order it. What is the website? It's victoriabowlin.com, right?
Right, victoriabowlin.com, and Bowlin has no G, so it's Bowlin.
Yeah, Victoria, Bowlin. Go out there and order it. Some people still like to get a physical CD in their hand, so you can go to the website and order it. But you need this album because it's interesting, it's exciting, it's different, it's one of a kind, and we love it. We want you to have it. Victoria, I appreciate your time for being our featured artist all week long and for being with us today.
Oh, well, thank you for having me. It's been a joy.
Yeah. Well, you've got a friend here on the morning show. Don't forget it.
Well, thank you so much.
All right. We'll do it again sometime. Thanks, Victoria.
All right. Bye-bye.
Special thanks to Victoria Bowling for spending some time on the morning show. I hope you have a fun weekend. Hey, I was going to go out with this. It's Friday, and I just thought it'd be a whole lot of fun, but I chickened out. But you need to go look up the song. The song by Natasha Owens. It's called Trump Won. Now, if you're easily offended, just go ahead and turn the channel right now and quit listening. I was going to play it, but I don't have the nerve to, but it did hold the number one spot on the iTunes charts for several days this week. Hey, we all know Trump won. So look, I'm not going to play it. I don't want to, you know, I love to stir it. I really do, but I'm going to let it go today and we'll go with something less controversial like Shenandoah on the morning show. Have a good one.
But go listen to it. Back in Tennessee. Ain't no place I'd rather be sitting next to you, next to me. How you been? How you been? How you been? Picking right up with some real old friends. Been so long it should be a sin, but here we are again. We're having a revival. Good Lord, hallelujah. These red dirt road disciples got spirits running through us. It's rowdy reminiscing and tailgate conversation. Yeah, we got this down home, hometown congregation. Hey.
electric strings by the fire. Everybody singing like a choir. Another year older and wiser, but we ain't gonna act our age.
No way!
How you feel, how you feel, how you feel? Any kind of nice seeing mud on the wheels. All these trucks circled up in the field just like we used to do. We're having a revival. Good Lord, hallelujah. These red dirt road disciples got spirits running through us. It's rowdy reminiscing and tailgate conversation. Yeah, we got this down home, hometown congregation. Having a revival, revival, revival. Having a revival, revival, revival. Ooh. Ooh. Call us prodigal sons, all in town for some fun. Disciples got spirits running through us. It's rowdy reminiscing and tailgate conversation. Yeah, we got this down home, hometown congregation. Having a revival. Good Lord, hallelujah. These red dirt road disciples got spirits running through us. It's rowdy reminiscing and tailgate conversation. Yeah, we got this down home.
Been listening to The Morning Show with Natalie Duncan-Emmons. We're glad you joined us. We want to invite you back tomorrow when once again you'll hear some of the very best in gospel music and some of the finest in Christian entertainment. Will you join us tomorrow? Is it a date? We'll look for you then. God bless and goodbye, everybody.